So the first card is the Nest, which says an emotionally secure and loving family is important to you. So you're concentrating a lot on your family at the moment. And just be careful not to take any risks, because you don't want any harm to come to you. So just make sure that you're, you know, taking it easy. No need to rush into things. Someone is working against you behind your back. So just watch out. There might be people that are not really for you. And it might be somebody from your family in itself. So, you know, they could be stirring up some problems over there. So in the past, you've got the Vulture, which says depression, anxiety, worry that someone is against you. So you are aware that something is not going your way and that people are not really for you. So you've got the Scissors, which says disappointment in some affairs. You might have had some family disappointment going on as well. And, you know, this has caused the depression, anxiety. So somebody's let you down. So going to the future, you've got the Cracked Cup, which, you know, you're feeling a bit down right now. And it says, beware of great pride. So you might need to just, you know, have a little bit of humility. Maybe you need to ask some advice from somebody you don't really want to ask for advice from. But it might be something that you do need to discuss your feelings with. You know, because you are feeling a bit depressed right now, like something has gone wrong. There was, there's a broken cup over there and you're feeling a bit down. You know, people not really supporting you, and you are feeling as though, you know, you are. So you've got the Lovers cards coming in. So you, there's a big decision that you have to make right now. And it's probably to do, you know, whether to take the plunge and do something that you haven't done. Take that risk and do it. It might involve love or something to do with family, since the previous read was about family a lot. And a big decision coming up about what to do next in the situation. So you're faced with quite a big choice right now. So what's going on around you? You've got the King of Pentacles and the Ace of Wands. So, you know, you might be dealing with a a new job offer coming in for you. With the King of Pentacles, maybe you're dealing with a boss. Somebody is in charge of the situation. Somebody that's very much, you know, a businessman kind of. And maybe there's a new offer that they're giving you. So they want you to do something new, a new project, a new job offer. And maybe this is the choice that you have to make as to whether or not to take this particular job. So in the past year or so, you've been dealing with the Tower card. So a lot of disruption, loss, you know, financially, problems that you've been dealing with, you know, a lot of things coming to light, a lot of revelations. And you've also been faced then with, you know, in the last 3 months about whether to move forward from the situation of the Tower, where there's so much of problems, or to stay in that situation. So you're still facing that kind of a decision as what to do next, how to move forward, how best to move forward. And it looks, this woman looks a bit depressed. So you are a bit frustrated as to how to do it. You know, either way, it's going to take a lot of hard work, and maybe you're not too happy with it. So you've got the Knight of Cups. You do want something, somebody to come in and support you emotionally. You're looking for that emotional support from someone, and you're hoping that they give it to you in order for you to you know, have a shoulder to cry on, somebody to lean on while you make this decision. So in the Five of Swords, going into the future, there was a lot of, or you're dealing with a lot of problems right now. You know, vindictive talk, behavior, people cutting your chances, people giving you a lot of grief, a lot of heartache. You know, a lot of domination, people just, you know, there's, it's a very nasty situation that you're dealing with. You've got so many scissors here cutting things. You know, you're trying to move forward, and people not allowing you to move forward because there's so much of chaos going on around you. So you are trying to focus a lot on your work. So maybe you've, you know, your job, you're focusing on learning as much as you can, applying all your skills, and you're getting a lot of admiration. You might be working with a lot of people, and money is starting to come in from this job where you're focusing a lot of your time and effort on it. So this problems could be within the family life as opposed to your work life, because it seems like everything is pretty much sorted as far as your work goes, and it looks like you are going to be getting some sort of new job offer coming in with this Ace of Wands, or a new project that you have to do, and you know, with the King of Pentacles supporting you. This might also be a new leadership role that you're getting being offered right now. So around you, there's the Five of Wands. So you know, these are the people that you are with, working with. Maybe you're working with them. This could also be family. So there's a lot of problems, dissent, different petty arguments, things that you're not really happy with, you know, all that coming into play. So you're having to deal with a lot of chaotic situations, harsh words, nasty behaviors, but also, you know, people, petty arguments, people starting fights for no reason. And you're trying to sort everything out. You're trying to put out the flames everywhere while you're trying to get on with your job. So you have the Knight of Wands. There is somebody there that, well, this could, the Wands cards really indicate the fire signs. So this could be you trying to rush into battle. You're grabbing everything you can and trying to defend yourself. So try not to do that. Try not to rush into battle. Try not to get yourself involved into situations where it can only escalate into something worse. And the fights are really childish, because you can see this is a child on a bicycle. And the Five of Wands always talks about childish arguments, petty arguments. So try not to get yourself riled up over things that are insignificant at the end of the day, because it could escalate to something and that could be worse. So going into the future, you've got the Page of Pentacles, the Queen of Cups, and the Sun. So with the Page of Pentacles, a new job offer coming in, definitely. And it is something that you're going to have to start a little, you know, from the bottom and work your way up to the top. It also could mean extra training, extra learning, extra courses. But with it, there's a lot of hard work. And you can see starting from the bottom, there's a child there. But a lot of money will come in. So whatever hard work you invest in this particular job will pay off. So you're getting news about that. And that's coming in for you soon. And it's going to make you, you're feeling a bit depressed, upset, you know, like your glass is half. So maybe you're not half empty, rather. You're not really happy about what has happened. You've been through a lot of problems recently from all the readings with Aries. So, you know, you are feeling a bit despondent with life, like it's not giving you what you wanted. But you are getting there slowly. It's coming back into your hand. You know, your power is getting into your hand again. So try not to be depressed and overanalyze things. And see the positivity rather than the negativity of things. And then you've got the Sun card coming in over here. So you will achieve whatever you want with the card. A lot of clarity coming in. But, you know, after a lot of hard work, a good payoff. So you will get what you want. It's going to take that hard work. So this Page of Pentacles is talking about investing hard work and studying. And the Sun is saying that you will achieve everything that you need to achieve. So just hang in there and go for it. And all these petty disagreements that are going on around you, just, I think, just walk away from it and ignore it. Because this new job offer that you're getting here is going to bring you into a leadership position. It's going to allow you to study and learn a lot more on the job. And eventually, you end up achieving everything that you need to achieve with the Sun card. But it does come with a lot of hard work. So you do have to make that choice about taking this particular job. And, you know, it will end up paying in the end. So I'm drawing some cards from the Angel Tarot. So you've got the Chariot over here, which says an important achievement, self-discipline and willpower, public recognition. So you are getting recognized for all your hard work. That's for sure. And, you know, you are achieving your goals. You just have to hang in there, have some willpower and a lot of self-discipline. You've got to work hard for this particular post. You've got the Ego card, which says a false sense of entrapment, being overly focused on material things, negative or fear-based thoughts. So stop overthinking everything and know that you have the abilities to be able to do this and get it on the road. So you'll be able to overcome these problems. So act with more confidence. And the Moon card is talking about important psychic insights, events behind the scenes, release fears that hold you back. So it looks like with this Moon card, things are helping you even though you're unaware of it. And you're going to have, you know, follow your instincts because you've got great psychic insights here. And, stop being afraid of doing things. So be bold. And even the Sun card, it does talk about being bold, have that energy of the Sun, and act with confidence, and you will achieve everything you need to achieve. So I hope that this reading has resonated with you. It looks like you will overcome things, important decision to make, but forget all the petty arguments and bickering that's going on around you and the chaos that's going on around you. Focus on your work, really, and it will guide you into a better times.